ancient temples and historical towns, a memorial to a fallen statesman, and a group of people with speed in their veins. We see all this and more as we travel down a highway which links countries and cultures. Welcome to Follow the Star, and Vanakkam to Tamil Nadu. Our journey through Tamil Nadu will be divided into two parts, which we will cover driving on two highways. The first journey will be from Vellore to Chennai along the AH45 or the Asia Highway 45. And our second journey will be from Chennai to Puducherry along the State Highway 49, better known as the East Coast Road. On this journey down the AH45, we will be passing towns like Arcot and Sriperumbudur before we finally finish our trip in Chennai. I will also be making a slight detour from the AH45 to visit the holy town of Kanchipuram, post which I will be coming back to the AH45. I have been told that the first stretch of the road between Vellore and Arcot is a 6-lane highway of very good quality. Post Arcot, the road becomes a 4-lane highway whose quality is intermediate. I have also been told to watch out for the traffic near the industrial town of Sriperumbudur, which is heavy and continues to be so till we reach Chennai. In Chennai, I am going to be meeting Deepika Palikkal, India's number one squash player, who is also ranked 10th in the world. I start my journey early in the morning from the university town of Vellore. The most impressive attraction of Vellore is the Mahalakshmi Golden Temple. Situated in the spiritual park called Sripuram, the Golden Temple is supposedly made out of a ton of pure gold. And as soon as I get out of Vellore, I hit the AH45. It's a beautiful 6-lane highway, and driving in the early morning with not that much traffic is a joy. Now the acronym AH, as in AH45, stands for Asian Highway. A highway which is part of a cooperative highway network between different Asian countries. This network is supposed to help trade between different countries and trade within countries. This specific highway, the AH45, is the highway which runs from Dhaka to Kolkata to Bangalore. So my first stop on the AH45 is the town of Arcot. Because it's only 25 kilometers away from Vellore, it is also sometimes called a suburb of Vellore. Though this historical town has enough of its own to set it apart from Vellore. Arcot was once famous for a battle won by Robert Clive, though now all that remains are a few ruins which nobody visits. And in Arcot, I have to accomplish one task: taste its very famous Makkan Pera, also known as the Arcot Sweet. The Makkan Pera is a sweet which from the outside might resemble the Gulab Jamun, but it's what's inside that makes this sweet different from the Gulab Jamun. And the place where I am heading to taste the Makkan Pera is the Arcot Chettiar Sweet Stall. That is, if I can find it, because all the shop names are in Tamil. the Akad Chettiar sweet stall is the oldest and the most famous makers of the Makkan Peda. This tiny shop is over 180 years old, and I am meeting P.D. Sundaram, the fifth generation proprietor. Can I try?
Yes, work.
Yeah.
Sure.
It is so sweet. Looks like gulab jamun.
No. This is makkan peda. This is only jamun. This is special makkan
peda. This is gulab jamun.
Yes.
What is difference between two?
इसमें है क्या है? इसके अंदर गोवा दही वगैरह मिलाते हैं, ड्राई फ्रूट मिलाते हैं इसके अंदर.
ड्राई फ्रूट?
किशमिश, बादाम, अखरोट, खजूर सब कुछ मिलाते हैं इसके अंदर.
It looks like the gulab jamun, but I'm telling you, you can actually taste all the dry fruits that have gone into it. It's rich, superb sweet. I've never tasted something like this before. So, makkan peda ka history kya hai? Makkan peda invent kaise hua?
எப்படி செஞ்சு எப்படி வந்தது இதனுடைய வரலாறு அப்படின்னு கேட்குறேன்.
இது மக்கன் பிடா வந்து ஆற்காடு நவாப்புடைய காலத்தில் எங்கள் ஃபேமிலி ஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆற்காடு நவாப் அவங்க வீட்டில் வந்து நாங்கள் ஃபங்க்ஷனில் பார்த்து அந்த ஸ்வீட்டு அங்கேருந்து டேஸ்ட் எடுத்து வந்து இங்கே வந்து மாடிஃபை பண்ணி 11 ஐட்டமான ட்ரை ஃப்ரூட்ஸ் எல்லாம் இன்செர்ட் பண்ணி மக்கன் பிடா செய்கிறேன்.
The language sounds so sweet and I wish I could understand him and he could understand me. But I'm sure he's going to translate what he just said. Bataiye.
इनका ये कहने का मतलब है जो नवाब का जमाना था ना मुगलाय उनका टाइम से ये कर रहे हैं ये 1835 का
नवाब का जमाना से
यस 1835 में ये दुकान खोला
वाओ ओवर द इयर्स ये मक्खन पेड़ा का टेस्ट सेम ही रहा है
या
सो कांस्टेंटली दिस इज द टेस्ट ऑफ द मक्खन पेड़ा दैट योर परदादास हैड इन्वेंटेड वेरी गुड
लीविंग आकर एंड इट्स वेरी रिच मक्खन पेड़ा बिहाइंड वी क्रॉस द ड्राई रिवर बेड ऑफ द पलार रिवर and continue on the beautiful six-lane highway of the AH-45. After Arcot, there is a toll booth where the toll charges for a car is 30 rupees. Post the toll booth, right on the highway is a cafe called Isa Food Court. It not only has clean restrooms, but also serves what some locals call the best coffee in this region. I seem to be having an uneventful journey until something whizzed by.
Check out these super bikes! Oh my god! How many? Three? Four? He waved at me! I'm gonna try and catch up to him.
I finally managed to flag these super bikers down because I just had to. Check out those cool bikes.
See mine.
Hello.
Okay, so who are you guys? Tell me who you actually are.
We are a group of bikers from Chennai, call ourselves Wheat Twins. We have a group of about 15 members. We get together, go on trips. That's pretty much it. People who love motorcycles.
And how fast do these bikes go?
Really fast.
What is your favorite highway to ride your super bike on?
Okay, Kuppam. We've got this place called Mudaliyar Kuppam in Chennai. It's about 100 kilometers from my place exactly.
Okay.
So it's quite famous. Bikers frequent there every Sunday.
Those were some cool dudes with some very cool machines. Maybe on my next trip to Chennai, I'll ride one. Though right now, my ML class Mercedes is also pretty cool.
Since the toll, the highways changed from a three-lane highway to a two-lane highway. Although the roads aren't as great as the three-lane highway, they are still pretty good.
A few kilometers before Kanchipuram, I come to a fork at Kilambi. The AH-45, which goes straight to Chennai, bypasses the town of Kanchipuram completely.
So it's necessary to take that right turn on the fork at Kilambi if you want to visit Kanchipuram. We visit the temple town of Kanchipuram, where I find out the intricacies behind the making of the very famous Kanjivaram sarees. And finally, I reach Chennai, where I meet squash player Deepika Palikal, who tells me the secret behind her being first Indian woman to be ranked in the top 10 in the world. Welcome back to Follow the Star, where we are journeying in Tamil Nadu from Vellore to Chennai. I started my journey along the AH45 from Vellore and presently I've reached Kanchipuram. Kanchipuram is popularly called the city of a thousand temples, though I have heard there are only about 126 temples in reality. 126 temples is also a lot, and one can actually see a temple seemingly every 100 meters. The most famous of all these 126 temples in this very holy city is the Ekambareshwara temple. The temple's Gopuram is one of the tallest temple towers in India and can be seen from all over the city. Kanchipuram is also famous for its beautiful Kanjivaram sarees, and that is what I'm checking out. So here I am at the Arignar Anna Silk Co-op Society, and I'm trying to figure out the intricate secrets behind the making of these sarees. What is so special about Kanjivaram sarees?
Kanjivaram sarees has some uniqueness. It has solid border and solid body.
Okay.
And also solid pallo. This is done by weaver skill.
Okay.
The weaver is interlocking the weft from here, the border portion.
Okay.
And also another saddle is coming from here, and he interlock the thread,
the border and the body,
and create the solid border and pallu portion.
How much time does it take for your weaver to join these three parts together?
Pallu only he needs 2 days.
2 days to join for one sari.
To join pallu and create this pallu portion.
Now you know why Kanjivaram sarees are so expensive. I had no idea this was the reason, and I'm sure it's worth it after so much hard work goes into making one sari. Tell me something, Mr. Sami. What is the range? Like, how cheap to how expensive does it go? Because each sari takes the same amount of time, right?
Yeah. From 5,000 to 1 lakh rupees, we have sarees.
But can I see one?
Yeah, please.
Total
5.5 meters is filled with jari thread, golden jari thread.
So you weave with gold thread?
Gold.
The whole sari?
Yeah.
No wonder it's 1 lakh. And it actually feels 1 lakh rupees because it's heavy. Thank you so much, Mr. Sami. It was very nice seeing your beautiful sarees.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, I didn't have the time to pick up a Kanjivaram sari because I had to get back on the road to Chennai, for I had an appointment to keep with Deepika Palikal. From Kanchipuram, I rejoined the AH45 and continued to Chennai. Though it's just a 4-lane highway, the road conditions aren't that bad and the traffic too isn't much. Right after Kanchipuram, the countryside also becomes less populated. There were farms and fields ringed by coconut trees, which were very pretty to look at and certainly made me enjoy the drive more. Around 40 kilometers before reaching Chennai proper, we passed Sriperumbudur, the last big town on the AH45. Sriperumbudur is an industrial town as such, but it is remembered primarily for being the place where the former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated. A memorial dedicated to him is the biggest attraction in Sriperumbudur. There is a toll booth right after Sriperumbudur where the charges for a car is 45 rupees. After the toll, the road quality deteriorates a lot on this four-lane highway. Now that we're getting closer to Chennai, you can clearly see how the traffic is increasing. Finally, Chennai. And thankfully, I'm running on time to meet Deepika. Deepika Padikkal is India's top-ranked squash player, and she is also the first as well as the only Indian woman to have ever broken into the top 10 of the world rankings. And I was picking her up from her house. Hi, Deepika.
Finally.
I know,
it's
finally.
It's so great to meet you.
Are you tired? Long trip?
Super tired. Our journey from Vellore has been really, really tiring. But thankfully, the roads were just flat stretches and good roads. So
that was compared really to good Bombay, Chennai is an ease.
It's really, the roads are really nice. So that's the only saving grace. But otherwise, I'm just really tired. Yeah. So where are we going now?
Well, we're going to the second best place to me in this whole wide world. It's the gym, which I spend a lot of time out there for two reasons. Because the guy who owns the gym is my trainer, Basu Shankar. And two, it's the best gym in the world, so I train there.
Come, let's go. Okay. Deepika, tell me, do you drive around Chennai often?
I do. I actually love driving. I'm not obviously a fan of cars like all like the nation, my dad. But I do like driving, yes. It gives me some alone time in the car.
That's true. A lot of people say they think a lot when they drive and they go over their issues and the day and all sorts of things. Do you do that too?
I train really early in the morning at 6 o'clock.
So then that's a good time to drive.
Yes, the roads are empty, so you don't really have to stop anywhere, which I like when there's traffic, either my driver or the nation's driving.
Have you taken a lot of road journeys? Been on road journeys if you aren't driving, someone else has driven you?
When I have to spend time with family, that's the only time we actually get to spend in the car. So we try and do road trips once in a while.
Nice.
It was a quick drive through the streets of Chennai, and Deepika and I reached her gym soon enough.
So the second most important place in your life, this gym, you've told me that it's really important to you after your squash courts.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it so important? You wanted me to shoot here with you.
I think I play a sport where fitness is very, very important. You're only running all the time, so obviously the gym and fitness and track work is very important. So this is where I spend most of my time if I'm not on court. And this is why I thought this is actually the perfect place.
When did you start playing squash?
I started when I was 10 years old, quite young, but I was always involved into sport because I am from a background where my mom, a sports background where my mom played cricket for India. It was very important for me to actually take up sport. And I played tennis and basketball, and I did a few track and field events in school. But once I got onto the squash court, I loved it, so I didn't want to ever get off it.
So how long do you think your squash career is going to last?
Well, I'm only 23, so when people actually ask me that, I really don't have an answer. But obviously, as an athlete, I have a few goals. The main goal is to get to world number one and win a world championship. I love my game, that's why I play it. That's why there's a lot of sacrifices going on. And I think the most important thing is to enjoy yourself, because you're not going to get results until and unless you enjoy.
You're happy doing what
exactly.
You're doing.
Yes.
Meeting Deepika was great fun, because despite being a rising star in India, she still came across as the girl next door who was also very committed to her sport. And thus, the first leg of my journey in Tamil Nadu came to an end. Thanks to the quality of the road of the AH45 between Vellore and Chennai, my journey had been quite comfortable. The stretch between Vellore and the toll booth beyond Arcot had been a dream to drive on. and the four-lane highway post that wasn't that bad either, though nowhere as good as the six-lane highway. The traffic too hadn't been much until we reached the outskirts of Chennai. This route also did have something for everybody. Pit stops for the hungry as well as pit stops for the shopaholics. For those interested in history and culture, there was Vellore and Arcot to explore. And Arcot even had something for those with a sweet tooth. Kanchipuram too, with its temples and beautiful silk saris, was worth the slight detour from the AH45. And if you're lucky like me, you even might encounter a superbike group like the Wee Twins. And it is these kind of chance meetings and experiences which actually make a trip special. My next journey will be along the beautiful East Coast Road from Chennai to the erstwhile French colonial town of Puducherry. Along the way, we chance upon a secluded beach, meet up with two brothers teaching kids how to surf, as well as meet actress and designer Aisha Kapoor. And in Arcot, I have to accompany to taste its very famous ice pat. And in Arcot, I have to accomplish. What is wrong with me? Straight right. Makkan pera. Okay. Thank you.
Oh. Nee, khol na.